Renegade Health Radio.
Renegade Health Radio. This is Kevin Gianni with Frederick Patnaud. Hey, Fred.
Hey, Kevin. How are you doing today?
I'm excited. We've just launched the weekend cleanse. People are getting really excited about it in Renegade Health Land. It's a good thing.
Yeah, I'm excited too. I mean, we've been working on this for a while, and it's been great to see the reaction to the launch and everything. And I think people are going to get a lot of value out of it. And also, it was interesting to see how we launched the product, the Weekend Cleanse, and what you revealed during the launch, and then also the discussions it led to.
I'll tell everyone out there some behind the scenes. Frederick essentially suggested. I mean, I've been meeting with Frederick for the past, almost year, just to put together all the things that we need to do for Renegade Health. And Fred suggested that, that I tell my weight gain story. And I was a little bit uneasy about it at first. I'm telling the story in the book, but I didn't know if I wanted to, I don't know, what was it called? Let the cat out of the bag kind of thing. but we did. And the feedback was really great. I think it does, Fred. And a lot of people put us on pedestals, right? And the reason that we have this 100% certified guru free stamp on the podcast logo is because we really don't want anyone to put us up on a pedestal. And I think telling my own personal story, having a son, running two businesses, eating out in some of the most amazing farm-to-table restaurants on the planet here in Berkeley, I think that's kind of an every man and woman story. That's the kind of a story that everyone kind of experiences and wonders. And I gained weight, about 25 pounds, maybe a little bit more. And it was, it was really frustrating. It was one of these things where I think that the culmination of it was in January when I, after the holidays, and Fred had visited in December, and I'd been home with friends, and I let my guard down in terms of my eating, not particularly, not awful. I mean, I wasn't going to McDonald's or anything like that. I was still eating, fresh, fruits and vegetables and meats and things like that from Whole Foods and organic, all this sort of stuff. I came home and I had a pair of pants that I hadn't worn over the holidays. I hadn't brought them with me when we were back in Connecticut, and I pulled them up, and literally my legs were in them tightly. Like I felt like, my legs felt like sausages. And I'm sure some of you out there, recognize that feeling. It was the first time it had really ever happened to me. And I went to button the jeans and I couldn't button the top button. And there was a button fly, there were Levi's. I couldn't button the top button. And I looked in the mirror and I just said to myself, I said, is this really what just happened? And then I'm like, well, obviously this didn't happen overnight. And I guess I'm lucky enough to be a person where my weight doesn't actually, it doesn't show that much on me. So you look at that image, that's 200 in the image on the blog that's me at 223 pounds. And I've never been 223 pounds before. That's crazy weight. And so that's where I was with my, unable to button my pants in front of a mirror, just thinking like, well, man, maybe I'll just wear like sweatpants to work because at least they'll fit, and I realized that I suddenly became, a seeker, someone who probably, probably some of you out there who've come to the blog looking for answers. And so then, I said, what the heck am I going to do? And, I called upon this cleanse that I've done before that I just know is an amazing jumpstart, something that I created and then Fred helped Fred probably had a similar cleanse and we kind of, in terms of like, doing this sort of jumpstart thing, cause we know how valuable it is. And it was just one of these things where we just kind of like, I just sat down and I said, I'm just going to do this just to see if I can at least get a little dent in not only this weight, but in my energy, in my emotional well-being about everything. And, I did it and it worked out great. I lost about, 5 pounds. Some of that's water weight. I'm not saying that you're going to lose 5 pounds of fat in 3 days. It's almost, it's almost unbelievable in terms of that. And it's probably a goal that I wouldn't want you to set for yourself. But it was a great jumpstart because I felt lighter. I felt better. My energy level was higher. I felt like I was moving forward. And then since then, I've really kind of stepped it up, and I think I've lost maybe 27 plus pounds now since January. And I done the weekend cleanse about three times since then, just to kind of continue that pattern of just you know getting a little bit off course and then coming back to this cleanse to just get that jump start again. And I probably have about 10 more pounds to lose, but man, you know. So that'll be a total of like 37 pounds. And 37 pounds, it's amazing. It just, you know, it snuck up on me.
That's amazing. I have a few thoughts on that. I just want to tell people again, if you're kind of brand new to us or you're wondering what the hell we're talking about, go to renegadehealth.com/weekendcleanse to learn about our latest program. And while you were talking, Kevin, I was thinking, you know, I wanted to mention that you kind of went to two different extremes. I wouldn't say that the recent episode was necessarily an extreme, but your previous one where you were a raw foodist was kind of an extreme. Not extreme in the sense that it's necessarily bad for anybody for everybody to go on a raw food diet, but the way you did it and the results it led you to was kind of extreme in a sense that you needed some adjustments. And I know exactly what you felt because I was there at some point. I was thinking, I gotta stop this 100% raw food diet. It's not, you know, it's not the best for me necessarily, but I don't know where to go from that point. You know, I want to keep some of the good stuff from the raw food diet and veganism and so on. But where do I land after? And then sometimes it takes a rough landing where you just go in the other direction and you just kind of eat a bunch of everything. And then you realize, oh, that's not working either. So you have to find the in between. And I think that's what your story is about, you know, you finding that, okay, now I'm living a healthful lifestyle, but it's not exactly where it was before, like two steps forward, one step back kind of thing.
I mean, look, I would love to eat as much bacon as humanly possible. I mean, that's, you know, bacon is one of those foods that just tastes ridiculously amazing. And we have a butcher shop I could see it if I just walk up to the end of my block here, from, you know, that's right around the corner. And yeah, you know, the pigs are humanely raised. I mean, you know, someone might argue, you know, about whether, you know, killing pigs at all is humane, but, you know, the pigs are humanely raised and, you know, we know the source and where they're coming from and all that sort of stuff. And, you know, a lot of people will argue that, you know, bacon and eating grass fed butter and all these things are great for you, but these are highly concentrated foods. And so my own story, you know, I went from raw food, which is, you know, the raw food diet is an extremely cleansing diet. And, you know, so I went from raw foods and my adrenals getting wrecked and, you know, having really low energy and my having my hormones all out of whack to essentially saying, screw it. You know, I live in Berkeley here. We're going to eat, you know, the majority of our food, maybe 90% of it is going to be organic just because of the nature where we live, which is like the epicenter of local farm to table food. So I'm just going to eat whatever. I'm going to eat high concentrated foods. I'm going to eat bacon. I'm going to eat sausage from, you know, this amazing butcher shop. I'm going to eat, you know, breakfast and eggs and, you know, all these things that I just really didn't eat before. And just a little bit as just like a, you know, screw you to the whole health movement, but also as a, you know, I just have to do something different because I'm so disheartened by the health movement that I just need something else to do. And again, it, you know, Fred, you brought up the great point is that neither of them worked, right? So neither of these things work. And so for me now the message is, and what I'm doing right now in my own personal life that's helped me lose this weight is just look at, you know, the in-betweens and look at the idea, you know, can you have your cake and eat it too? So can you be healthy and take some of the things from the healthy lifestyle? And can you also have these things that you just don't want to give up, you know? So there's some things like every once in a while, I want to have something that I just don't want to give up, and can I have it? And can I still live a healthy, happy life? And obviously the results so far since January are showing to be positive in that favor.
I think you can follow a philosophy of and versus a philosophy of or. That's something I learned from a psychologist a couple of years ago that kind of really helped me, is people always think it has to be either or, you know, but sometimes it's psychologically, at least, it's really helpful to see it as you can do this and that, you know, you can live a healthful lifestyle and, you know, occasionally have some fun. And also, or you could drink moderately during the year and also once in a while go 30 or 60 days without alcohol. You know, doing these things is it kind of goes against the philosophy of living a moderate life constantly, like meal by meal. But I think it's more in tune with our human nature, that sometimes there's periods of abundance, sometimes there's periods of scarcity. So you have to, you know, have to realize where you're at and think, you know what, right now I want to do a cleanse. I want to try a 3-day cleanse, like the weekend cleanse. I want to try a little bit of fasting or go on a raw food diet for 30 days, you know, or the entire summer. But when you put an end date to it, you say, okay, I'm going to do it until that date. That kind of removes a lot of the psychological drama of doing this extreme kind of, I'm going to do this for the rest of my life. And then you have the cravings and you torture yourself. You know, it's so much easier not to do this when you kind of set just pretty much clear rules and you say, hey, I'm going to do this. And I think it comes with age a little bit. I mean, when I was in my early 20s, I tended to be really militant and intense about these things. And now in my late 30s, I'm like, yeah, you know, I can chill out a little bit and do things more moderately in that sense that I just described.
But I think in terms of health, I mean, your life, many times your life is defined by, you know, big events, right? And big things that happen, whether you publish a book and it hits a bestseller list, or, you know, someone, you know, you lose someone that is really close to you. So like, you know, your life, like your emotional life is defined by, you know, success and trauma, you know, in many ways. And you can work out of that. So it's not, you know, in ways of, you know, using like emotional freedom technique and things like that. But with health, I think your life is more defined with kind of like the overall picture of what you did from beginning to end. So it's not like, what you ate yesterday is going to make a huge impact on your life. It's what you ate for all your meals. And so if you had, you know, I'm just going to say a crazy example. If you ate like Fruit Loops yesterday because you were stranded somewhere and you didn't want to fast, and the only thing that was there was a box of Fruit Loops, and that was like the thing that you just absolutely needed. And again, illogical. I probably would fast if that was the only option I had. But say you just ate Fruit Loops for breakfast. That's not going to define your health. It doesn't define you who you are, particularly if you're eating, you know, say you have a green smoothie in the morning, you have a salad for lunch, you have a reasonable dinner, you know, with lots of fiber and vegetables and for dinner, you know, I mean, it's like that aberration doesn't define your life like it would in the emotional kind of spectrum. You know, in the emotional spectrum, you know, something could, you know, really could set you off, and that could put you on a totally different path. But with your health, it's more of a thing where it's just that whole picture of start to finish. And so the more that you can stack the deck in your favor and just put good foods into your diet, one, the more those other foods are going to be kind of crowded out, and two, they're just not going to mean as much in terms of the whole spectrum.
Mm. Completely.
So anyway, the weekend cleanse is the way to get started. And that's why we presented it to you, because if you're out there right now thinking, man, I do need some sort of jumpstart, this is it. Because when you look at cleanses these days, I mean, the girls in the office right now, and I say the girls in the office because there's only one other guy there with me, so it's essentially all the girls, and we actually both have strong, like, you know, feminine signs, like at least in Chinese face reading and things like that. We had a Chinese face reader come in, and she was just like, wow, you know, it seems like there's two guys here, but in terms of your readings, you kind of fit into the whole feminine center of the, you know, circle of the office here. But anyway, they're doing a cleanse right now. It's 21 days, and man, like 21 days, that's a lot. And you know, I already hear them saying, well, you know, when can I drink coffee again? You know, I'm really craving sugar. I'm really having this, you know, I'm just kind of depressed and I'm emotionally distraught about all this. And that's cool. But, you know, I think that what they really need, because they haven't done a cleanse in a while, I really think the jumpstart is more emotionally satisfying, because the thing about the 21-day cleanse, which has its place, you know, it definitely has its place. But the thing about the 21-day cleanse is that if you hit a bump in the road and you don't complete it, you've set yourself up to emotionally believe that in some way you're a failure by doing this whole cleanse, and that's not cool. And so we did a quick cleanse like this, a jump start, because we know that anyone can take a weekend and, you know, sit around and relax a little bit, catch up on some sleep. I mean, even if you have kids, you can still do this. You know, I did it with Hudson here, and Emery didn't do it, but you know, we're here, and I spent a day with him while I was doing it. So, I mean, you can totally do it. And it's just the best way to get that motivation to then go on and do the next thing, which may be the 21-day cleanse. So like, it's like, you know, put a check on the list and then move on to the next thing.
Or you just do the weekend cleanse a bunch of times like you did. I mean, you do it like a few times a month. I mean, it's not like, just to clarify for people, a cleanse like we're talking about is not, you know, you're not going to live on maple syrup and lemon water for a couple of weeks. Like, you know, and it involves, yes, there's a little bit of water fasting, which is optional to get the whole thing kickstarted, and then it involves juices and smoothies and herbs, but it's very easy actually. I mean, when you see the actual layout, you'll realize it's easy and that you can do it, you know. And yes, the second day is a little challenging. I mean, you've experienced that, I've experienced that, but it's not like challenging to the point where you're thinking about giving up, because you know, oh, you have one more day and then it's over.
Yeah.
And then by the time you reach the end, you're like, wow, this has been a great experience. And then it kind of sets you up for what you're going to do next. Maybe you're going to change a bunch of unhealthy habits right after. Now you feel inspired to do it. And maybe you're going to do the cleanse again, or you're going to do a different cleanse eventually or something like that. And then over the course of, let's say, 6 months or 3 months, doing all these things and these changes, I mean, you're going to really transform your health, if I can use this cliche, but that's really what can happen.
Yeah. And I think that, you know, the best thing about the cleanse is that generally what happens when someone does a cleanse like this, and any cleanse for that matter, is that you take one thing that really resonated with you and you do it for a while. So for instance, for me, after I did the cleanse, the one thing that I did, and essentially it was like it's kind of like my breakfast reset button, this cleanse. So before the cleanse, I was eating just, I don't know, when I was at home, my mom would make eggs for breakfast, and, you know, we'd sit and we'd have some toast, and, you know, maybe if she had bacon, I'd have some bacon and that sort of thing. And I mean, it tastes good, right? That stuff tastes delicious. And, you know, it does add to your waistline. And so after the cleanse, you know, on day three, there's a few smoothies, and I took one of those smoothies and I just modify it every day. And that has been my breakfast for, what is it now? It's May. So that's been my breakfast for 5 months almost.
So, all right. Give us the recipe, Kevin.
You want the recipe? Yes, I will. It's one head of romaine lettuce, a full head of romaine lettuce. It is one or two scoops of protein powder. I use the Sun Warrior Warrior blend, and then there is I will transition between berries and either mangoes or let's see what else, berries, mangoes, cherries. pears. Yeah. Any fruit, I'll just add, I don't know, a handful of each. So I'll do two fruits. I'll just kind of mix two and then pop it in, blend it. If I have green juice left over, we have green juice every, every two to three days of the week. We make a green juice, a bunch of it, and we save it. And if I have green juice left over, instead of adding water, I'll add the green juice. I did that this morning. I added the green juice, which is a combination of apple and kale and fennel and cucumber and celery and I think carrot, maybe a little carrot. So parsley too. So
it's an intense smoothie. I mean, you need like a Vitamix or
yeah, you do.
Or one of those blenders. And by the way, I just want to say, if you're thinking about a blender, what's your vote, Kevin, between the Vitamix and the other?
Vitamix.
Me too. I would say Vitamix between, you know, that and the Blendtec. I mean, to me, you really need that plunger to make those. But
you know what it's like? It's like driving a standard or an automatic car. Like the automatic car is the Blendtec, right? It just kind of like goes and you can't really adjust it, particularly if you run into a rough spot, like in the snow. Like, it's really great to have a standard car with the stick shift, you know? And then the Vitamix is like having the stick shift, you know?
Except so
like,
that it's easy to operate for a first timer.
Yeah, it's a lot easier to operate. Yeah. So.
Great. Well, thanks, Kevin, for sharing your story and having well, do I need to say the courage or the guts to say, yeah, you know, I got off track and then I went back on track and this is what I did. And I think, I mean, that's going to inspire a lot of people. And, you know, if you guys listening out there want to give it a try, it's also very inexpensive. We made it very inexpensive, the Weekend Cleanse. So it's not like you're going to show up on the page and, oh my God, $197. No, no, I won't tell you the price, but just go there and check it out. renegadehealth.com/weekendcleanse and get on board. And we're creating a community on Facebook, only people who purchased, but once you buy it and you get the program and you can join the community, I mean, it's a great place where people can exchange thoughts and even ask us questions on the cleanse.
All right, guys. So if you like this podcast, make sure you give us a review on iTunes. You can find us, Renegade Health Radio. Search on the top right. Give us a review. Give us 5 stars. Give us 4 stars. Give us 1 star. Tell us what you hate about us. Anything. Just make sure Apple pays attention to us. This is important information. We've got to get the word out there. We need your help. Take care.
All right. Thank you.
Renegade Health Radio.